Welcome back to 288X. I'm Professor John Hart from MIT, and today we'll focus on additive manufacturing, which you may also know as 3D printing. Now, even if you've never used a 3D printer or designed a part for additive manufacturing, you know that this represents a very important technology to manufacturing now and more so in the future. And we can see many examples of this importance based on what industry is doing with additive manufacturing. For example, GE starting to print parts out of metal for their jet engines, Google thinking about deploying modular products such as smartphones, where the cases are made using 3D printing, doctors printing custom parts to save people's lives using 3D printing, and consumer products companies such as Nike thinking about making custom personalized shoe soles. We'll get back to these examples later on, but you may have also heard that 3D printing was invented at MIT, and that, in terms of one particular process that's still used today, is in fact true. This is a photo of one of the first parts made on MIT's 3D printer, made about 25 years ago. At that time, Professors Ali Sachs and Michael Sima and colleagues invented the 3D printing technology, which involved building parts up layer by layer from a powder-based material, where the powder was glued together using an inkjet printing technology. Now, this is a small model of the Hagia Sophia, a famous landmark in Istanbul, Turkey, and you can see the fine level of detail they achieved, and also that the part has hollow internal cavities. That's one of the hallmarks of the flexibility of 3D printing, and that was seen and demonstrated in this part. In fact, I have one of the several remaining parts that floats around various offices at MIT here in my hand, and we can see it under the camera. And by looking at the top surface of a part, you get the sense of the fine degree of texture as well as the granularity. That's both a strength and a weakness of 3D printing overall. And if I turn it at an angle, you see the tall, thin features that could be created, as well as the layers from the side, the step staircasing of the side of the part, and the internal cavities that I mentioned before. So this immense flexibility in geometry, as well as the limitation in the resolution and level of detail, is an important attribute when comparing and contrasting what additive manufacturing can do compared to conventional manufacturing.